Welcome back to Ditch the Diet Club. Today is lesson two, maximizing volume and nutrition. So a lot of the traditional approaches to weight loss involve calorie counting. And the problem with calorie counting is that it doesn't take into account your body's own internal hunger and fullness cues. If you think about a small child or a baby, they'll stop eating when they've had enough to eat. They are not using their plate as a visual to tell them when they're finished. When we become adults, we often use the plate to tell us when it's time to stop eating, when if we were in tune with our own hunger and fullness, we'd likely be able to stop much sooner. So let's talk about the physical structure of the stomach. The stomach is a very elastic organ, so it expands as we eat more. The sensors that tell our brains that we're full are located at the top of the stomach. So let's say you were to eat a meal of 300 calories. The calories don't tell us anything about the volume of the stomach, of the food in the stomach. So you may have two slices of pizza, but not feel full because you haven't filled the volume of the stomach. Just to give you a better visual of this, let's look at 100 calories of different foods. This is 100 calories of olive oil. If you can see it, it's just at the bottom of the bag there. So this is to demonstrate the amount of volume that this would fill in your stomach. To compare that, this is 100 calories of chicken, or any protein would take up just about the same amount of space for 100 calories. Again, quite a small amount of space in the bottom of the bag here. And this is 100 calories of broccoli. You can very clearly see that the broccoli takes up the largest amount of space per calorie. So the benefit of this is that you will eat less at a meal when you have filled your plate with mostly vegetables. So now, with all three of the bags, you can see that each of these is a component of a healthy meal, but without the broccoli, we are less likely to fill that stomach to the point where it can communicate with our brains and tell us it's time to stop eating. The problem, going back to calorie counting, is that if we were to just eat 100 calories of meat or 100 calories of oil, we may never feel satisfied. And the problem is that at the end of the day, we then tend to overeat to make up for that feeling of being unsatisfied throughout the day. So hopefully today's lesson helped you understand why we need to look at more than just calories when we're looking to improve the way that we eat. Always consider the volume of a meal and think about filling your plate with those fruits and vegetables to help take up space in the stomach. Next week, lesson number three, we're going to be talking about the food spectrum. If you've ever heard a food called good or bad, or called yourself good or bad for a food that you ate or didn't eat, this lesson is for you. I'll see you next week.